First of all, I must congratulate all of you for this very historic milestone in the journey of this college. As Professor Chakrapani ji said, very few institutions can boast of a 100-year-old history. And it takes not only vision, and that vision for this college came from the 7th Nizam, Usman Ali Khan ji, who set up this college when there were hardly any colleges all across India. And we are seeing the product of that vision today. But apart from the, I would say, the starting of a college, it also requires hard work of thousands and thousands of people in this 100-year-old journey. And I'm happy that this college, as Dr. Bal Bhaskar ji said, stands as a first choice among government colleges of the state. In fact, the cutoff marks for this college, they always range in the high 90s, and this we are watching for last almost 2-3 years. We are very proud of the fact that nearly 1,500 students take admission in this college, but there are almost 10,000 students who ask for admission in this college through the DOST platform. And that is why the students who study in this college, I must say that you are very lucky. You are lucky to have a very, very good academic environment and also to have this great legacy, which I am sure that when you go out of this college, wherever you say that you have studied in Government City College of Hyderabad, that statement will be heard with great respect. And that is the benefit of studying in a college like this. And we have tried very hard to strengthen the faculty of this college. As Dr. Bal Bhaskar ji was telling, there are about 84 faculty members. I can tell you that, because I also look after the universities, many universities in the state of Telangana do not have 84 faculty members. I can say only two universities, that is Osmani University and Kakatiya University. They are the only two universities which have more faculty members than your college. All other universities have faculty less than your college. So you are, what I'm trying to say is, you are, though it may not be called a university, but it is more than a university. And the autonomy of this college is renewed by the hard work which Dr. Bal Bhaskar and all the faculty members and the staff of this college have put in. The renewal of the autonomy came in, and though our NAC grade in the last visit, that was pre-corona, was 2.76, we realized the reasons why there was little shortfall in the NAC grade, and that was mainly because of lack of faculty and lack of the research activities. So we tried to fulfill that gap by putting in all the faculty members who are mostly PhD and they also have a very good research profile. And I have requested Dr. Bal Bhaskar after this, because first task was to get this autonomy renewed. Now, having achieved that, the next task is to go in for NAC reaccreditation. And I'm 100% sure that this college will not only be crossing 3, but it will probably be crossing 3.25, which is A+ grade for the new NAC grading system. I also want to say that this college now provides number of options in studying various combinations. That is because of the flexibility which has been brought in the those platform, wherein students can choose not just fixed combination but any combinations. And I'm happy to say that some years back this college was only offering about I think 11 or 12 combinations, but today there are 55 combinations which students opt for. In fact, last year in November there was one combination which was opted by only one student, and when the principal wanted that student whether you are okay with this combination or you want to change into a more conventional combination, the student I remember was very very particular that this is the combination which I want to study. The reason is that we need to cater to the needs of the student, and that has been our objective both in this college as well as at state level, that what the students want to study, because ultimately it is their life, what is of interest to them, what they feel is the requisite knowledge which they need to do to be successful in their career, we are trying to provide that type of combination for the students to study. And I'm happy that this year we have been able to introduce two more new subjects, which is two more courses, which is BA Honours Economics and BA Honours Political Science. Though the time was very short for giving option for these combinations, I think there are hardly 2 days which were available for opting for these combinations. But we are very, very hopeful that these two courses will become courses which will produce really, really great minds of the future, both in economics and political science, because this option or opportunity was not available to the students of Telangana till now. And because of the efforts put in by a lot of thought leaders, especially Dr. Vinod Garu, who is the Vice Chairman of Planning Commission, and also our Vice Chancellor of Osmania University, and our Council of Higher Education, and our Commissioner was also involved, that we thought of bringing these two courses to, one to Koti College, Koti Women College, and also to Nizam College. Then when we decided to do that, we thought that City College should also be the college where we must have these courses. Because if the most coveted institution in the state is not having, then there's no point in having those courses. So we think that these two courses will become courses of future. Also, we really recognize the need for additional accommodation in this college, because this existing building, it's a very, very historic building. But as was told, this was designed for a limited number of students. And that's why we have requested our executive engineer of Telangana State Education and Welfare Infrastructure Development Corporation, which is TACWADC, to come here. And also we requested INTAC and Radhaji to be here so that we can discuss as to how do we increase the space in this college. And we should use this centenary celebration as a reason that we can build for the future. And also, parallelly, we want to upgrade and renovate this building to its past glory, because with time, lot of additions, deletions have been done, which probably have changed the character a little bit. But it's time that we look at it holistically and improve it. I'm happy that Didedar Bhatji was involved with the restoration of High Court, which is adjacent to us and which had an unfortunate fire incident about a decade back. but now it has been rebuilt. And Bachchi was telling that that is rebuilt in a way that it will last another 200 years. So similar thing we want for this college also, that it should celebrate one more centenary, the 200 years celebration should happen in a grand way in this building, because this building is also our history. Finally, I want to say a few words to the students who are in this college. As I said, that you are very lucky to be in this college. But I also want to tell you is that keep your aim, ambition or vision high for yourself. Don't work with a limited vision or limited objective for your life. Keep it high. The reason is that when you aim high, sometimes you may not achieve maybe that fully, but at least you go near that. But if our aim or ambition is low, then if we don't achieve that, we are even lower than that. And I can tell you that the principal and the faculty of this college is trying to ensure that whatever is required for the success of the students is provided. They also started a civil services coaching program some time back. And during this pandemic, all efforts were made to reach the students online, though our college was not functioning. But I am happy to say that all our faculty members were up and on online. And from the state side and from the commissioner side, I can say that whatever is possible to be done for this college, we will be doing. That includes additional accommodation, renovation of this premises, and upgrading the teaching learning infrastructure. And we are working on the plan, and we are very sure that with the help of the dignitaries who are present here, and many dignitaries who are not present here today but are supporting this college in a big way, we will definitely be able to take this college into the next league, even in terms of infrastructure also. And I also take this opportunity to call for the support of the alumni also. Bhatji is here. This is a great opportunity to involve the alumni. Because the reason why we celebrate many of these milestones is that these milestones are a time for us, one, to look back as to what we have achieved, how we have achieved, and also to look forward in the future as to where we want to go and how we can go there. And I think this is a great time for alumni to be involved in this the development of this college, and I'm sure that they will come forward in large numbers and with great support. So finally, once again, I congratulate all of you for this historic occasion. This is the inauguration of this centenary celebrations, and I'm sure that the celebrations will be celebrated in a very, very memorable way, memorable for the students as well as alumni and the faculty and the staff and the people around, which will be memorable for many, many years to come. And again, thank you for providing this opportunity to me to come here and be part of this celebration. Thank you very much and best wishes.